Greenfield Festival 2018 und jetzt haben wir We Came as Romans, Dave und Andy, die mich hier zum Interview teilnehmen bei uns. Nice to have you here, guys. Here in Interlaken, Switzerland. You just came out of Paris yesterday evening, played there. It must have been like hell there right now. It must have been crazy because it's just the European Championship of Football everywhere, people, you know, security and stuff. How was it?
It was really good for, you know, the first time ever being in Paris, and it was fun for us too because we got to watch a lot of bands that, you know, we grew up listening to, and we were stoked on like Deftones and Iron Maiden. So all around, I had a good time. It was great.
It was awesome. It was cool to be a part of it.
But the city itself, like, wasn't it like crazy because of the football European Championship? But you didn't see anything of that at all.
Not really.
Oh, really?
I mean, we might have, but we were asleep.
Also gestern Abend sind sie in Paris gsi und eigentlich ist ja gerade gestern Abend die grosse Europameisterschaft losgegangen natürlich im Fußball. Sie sind nicht mitbekommen, sie haben ihren Festival gespielt gehabt und das ist auch entsprechend abgegangen. And now you're here in Switzerland, Greenfield, Interlaken, a complete change of place, I guess.
Yeah.
Do you like it here? What do you
see? It's like teleporting. You just wake up in the next spot and you're like, where am I? It was pretty awesome. I mean, just being surrounded by the mountains and, you know, it's super beautiful here. So, I mean, that's always one of the most memorable things about this festival. When we did it a few years ago, we were like, man, the festival with the crazy mountains. And it's just awesome.
It's hard to keep your, like, mind focused when you're playing, too, because you see this sea of people, like, going nuts, which is awesome. But then you, like, look a little bit above it and you're like, ah.
So it's like you're playing and you're like, da-da-da-da-da, and then it's like.
Exactly,
you stop playing and you go, like, look on. And the guys would say, come on, keep on playing, dude. Exactly. Don't stop playing right now.
What are you doing? Mountains, man.
But the festival season has started. You know, it's summer, summer's coming. A lot of festivals will be coming in the next few months. Is it something you look forward to, the festival season?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the festivals here are awesome. It's a good way to make new fans and, you know, play for new people and play with bands that you normally wouldn't play with, maybe. So, yeah, it's awesome to be over here for the festivals.
Yeah, I always have fun because usually we come here like winter time, and you know what I mean. It's pretty cool, but over here in the summer, it's just like so nice, and yeah, all the festivals are huge, and kids just, you know, I feel like they really wait for the big festivals, and then when they do come out, they just let hell loose, and you know, they go nuts. Yeah, exactly.
Sounds good. Also, sie sind echt noch gern auf Festivals. Es ist eine Zeit, wo sie eigentlich auch noch gern die beglückwünschen, wo sie einfach noch gern daran teilnehmen, weil es doch auch sehr, sehr speziell ist. Und vor allem auch die Schweiz, es gefällt ihnen. Sie haben gesagt, hey, es ist doch auch schwierig, sich auf die Leute zu fokussieren während einem Konzert, währenddessen eigentlich da, wie es in Interlaken halt ist, rundum nur Berge sind und es einfach eine wunderschöne Aussicht hat. You just said that you, you know, you tour with new bands, but you toured with a very old band, you know, as a friend, actually. It's Memphis Mayfire, and you had a very special tour as well. It was called Bands versus Food. Also, Bands gegen Essen, eigentlich, kurz gesagt auf Deutsch. Which was basically just you going to different concerts and going to special restaurants at the same time. Am I right?
Yeah, I mean, we would basically get into a city and we'd ask our fans to, like, recommend a good spot, and then we would contact them and ask if they wanted to be involved. And they would basically cater the event, and our fans would get to buy like special tickets where we would all eat together and hang out together for, you know, half hour to an hour. I mean, yeah, it was really cool. It was a different way for us to connect with our fans because, you know, a lot of times you do these meet and greets and they kind of just like go through the line, shake hands, you sign their stuff, and they're on their way. You know, this is a cool way for us to actually like hang out with our fans and do something together and try food together. So yeah, it was really fun. And then, if a place didn't want to be involved, Andy would just go in acting like he was the owner, and we'd made him a stupid chef hat, and he'd go in and he drew a stupid mustache on him, and he would just go in and start like bossing people around, acting like he owned the place.
Did anybody believe it? No, I don't think so. It's the mustache.
No. One person that like, this guy's, they were like, this guy's an idiot. Like,
if you would have saw his hat and his mustache, you couldn't take him seriously. It was so funny.
Did they get the security or anything to throw you out again? Or?
No, they knew I was going to throw myself out. So they were like, he's going to take himself out back. Don't worry.
Yeah, we were like, don't worry. He'll wear himself out eventually. It'll be fine.
Just give it a few days and it will wear off and he will go out of the restaurant and you can go back home again.
Yeah, I mean, if anyone wants to see it, it is on our YouTube and it's pretty funny.
So what's the best thing you had then when you were like on all these fans meetings and all these food? What's it like one favorite you had there?
I mean, I think the coolest place we went to was this new Mexican spot called Sadie's.
Sadie's?
And the people there were so nice. Like, they just kept feeding us margaritas and queso throughout the throughout the whole time. And even though the food was really spicy, it was still really good. I don't even like spicy food, and I was like, this is really good.
I can't breathe anymore.
Just eating through the pain. Just
sweating.
But then later on when you go on the toilet before you have to go to bed, it's very,
let's not even talk about that.
Just, you know.
A very bad.
One end out the other, man. Tell you what.
Burning like a hell, I guess.
Circle of life.
Also, sie haben eine ganz spezielle Sache gemacht, nämlich in der letzten Tour geheißen Bands gegen versus Food, also Bands gegen Essen eigentlich, kurz gesagt. Und sie sind mit den Fans zusammen essen. Etwas anderes als das typische Meet and Greet haben sie gefunden. Wir gehen jetzt mal zusammen einfach mit den Fans Sachen essen, die sie vorschlagen, also an Restaurants, die sie vorschlagen. Und sie haben sich jetzt auch ganz lustig darüber gemacht, weil es einfach auch ganz speziell ist. Und ein Lieblingsort, wo sie gegangen sind, ist ein Mexican Place, wo natürlich ganz, ganz scharfes Essen hatte und auch einen entsprechenden Ausgang wieder von dem scharfen Essen, wenn ich das so zusammenfassen darf. I think you understood what I just said here, like, very easy. But I mean, there's some, you know, different foods you eat now, but when we're talking about food, it's a very, very big thing to talk about. So what's the best food there is in the world, if you could name one?
Best food in the world?
I think my favorite place to, I mean, I don't know, it's hard to say my favorite food, but my favorite place to go out to dinner and stuff is in Japan, like Tokyo and stuff, because you have to go in, you have to take your shoes off, you know, you sit on the floor, and then the food is always really crazy, like different kinds of sushi, and yes, and I'm
still alive.
In Bangkok, I ate a scorpion.
Really?
So that was cool, yeah.
I ate some crickets.
Oh, God, okay. Well, I think I ate crickets too, though, once, but I never had a scorpion yet.
I did. I was thinking about, they had tarantulas there, too. I was going to eat a tarantula, but
why didn't you then?
Because I already ate a scorpion. I was full, so.
You had to save the rest of his money
for
booze.
Well, like,
maybe next time when I go, I'll order the, you know, the stir-fried, you know, tarantula.
All right. Not for people who don't like spiders, I guess, but okay, it's not a problem there. What about Swiss food? How much do you know about Swiss food? It is famous. We can't. Don't say pizza, please. No.
I mean, just describe it, because I'm sure we've had
What's famous about Switzerland? You know, like, what do they have? They have the mountains. They have the banks.
Chocolate. Definitely
and
the chocolate.
Like one yellow thing with a lot of holes inside.
Oh, Swiss cheese.
Swiss
cheese is awesome.
So we have like some different kind of cheese, I guess. We've got the raclette. You know, it's like melted cheese.
Oh, yeah, I've had that.
You had that?
Yeah.
Well, kind of melted sandwiches. Cheese. There's different kind of melted cheese. It's raclette and fondue.
Oh, that's what
But you must have heard of fondue before.
Catering, yeah.
It's back there.
Yeah, I think so.
See, so you had Swiss food
I'm
here.
I'm going to go eat and come back, tell you how I feel about it.
Well, thanks so much. Make me like a little bit jealous.
I mean, Andy and I eat a lot of cheese. Sometimes we don't know what cheese we've ate because it's quite a bit. We like cheese.
A lot of years.
And then there's Kyle, our other singer. He like really, really, really hates cheese. Like, it makes him angry.
Cheese makes people angry.
Yeah, for him.
I don't know
he's
why.
He's really mad.
He gets so mad if there's cheese on his food.
What happens then?
He just takes it off and, like, throws it.
He just, well, he'll, like, push the plate and be like, I said no cheese.
Trying to speak to the microphone if you talk, sorry.
Oh, sorry.
It'll be difficult to...
he'll take the cheese off and throw it on the plate, or he'll push his plate away and be like...
Like a child.
Like a little kid, yeah, like a kid. Yeah.
But not with sprouts or anything that people don't really like. It's cheese.
Yeah, it's...
We tried to get him to eat this little cube of cheese the other day, this big. And what did we offer him? Like, we were each going to give him like $50 or something.
Really?
So it was going to be like 200 euro, and he wouldn't do it.
That man must hate cheese really, really, really bad.
But one day, he came to my house, and I looked in his car, and he had Goldfish, like the cheese snack. Says on the side, made it with 100% real cheese. And I'm like, why would you eat this? This is like everything you hate, like in a snack. And he had the big box, too.
He hates fish, too. So
he hates fish and cheese.
Yeah.
Although he eats fish with cheese flavor.
You don't want to know the things he likes. Just think the things he dislikes.
Oh, God. Also, a guy that hates cheese and goldfish. Although I don't know why people would hate goldfish.
I don't know.
They're forgetful, though, I guess. They forget really quickly.
Maybe he just had a bad experience with, like, cheese one day. Maybe he actually likes the way it tastes, but it's just bad memories.
Yeah.
What could have happened to people don't like cheese?
Something pretty bad.
Maybe a cheese wheel, like, fell and killed his cousin or something.
Downhill, and then, yeah, of course.
Died in that hot cheese accident.
Well, it sounds like
queso,
something that...
Queso spilling.
fell into the pot.
And then he could never smell cheese again. Yep. Very sad, actually. And yeah. It's very hard for him to be then here in Switzerland, where cheese is although a very big thing. And yep. Even in your backstage, there is a lot of cheese, as you told me, because I wasn't back there before yet.
So gonna start putting cheese in his bunk.
But that's... but you know... Why don't you just, you know, like, you know, take a piece of bread and take like something big and put inside, and then just put a little piece of cheese inside, which he doesn't see,
yeah.
And then make him eat it. And then when he ate it and he maybe didn't realize it, then you say,
you fucked up. You ate the cheese.
Go home.
And now we don't have to pay you.
Go to also, ein Bandmitglied von Ihnen hat Käse, wenn ich es wahrscheinlich verstanden habe, überhaupt nicht gern. Und das ist eigentlich noch speziell, weil wir sind hier in der Schweiz. Ich habe Ihnen gerade noch vorher erzählt, was verschiedene Käse in der Schweiz haben. Wir sind ja richtig stolz auf unser Fondue und auf unser Raclette und was es sonst ja auch noch gibt. Und es ist recht erstaunlich, dass der andere Herr von der Band dann gefunden hat, nein, Käse ist nicht für ihn. Er würde sogar das vom Essen nehmen, auf den Boden schmeißen, wenn es mal so serviert wird. Und lustigerweise hat er auch, ist er kein Fan von Goldfisch. Warum auch immer? Vielleicht gibt es eine Geschichte dazu. Wir wissen es nicht, sie hat gemeint, vielleicht ist mal ein Käserugel ihm am Cousin auf den Kopf gefallen, erst danach gestorben oder was auch immer. Wir werden es wahrscheinlich nie erfahren. Das ist dann am Dings sein Geheimnis schlussendlich. Well, enough of cheese.
How you did that, man? Like, I don't even remember what we just talked about.
Well, I just tried to, like, you know, and I just, you know, I say anything what I want, and you don't want to say it anyway, so I just can say what I want, and then it just sounds good, like, a new album's coming out, and it's going to be really good. They're going to be like, goldfish and cheese.
We're over here talking about cheese, and he's actually delivering.
It's all like Taylor Swift covers and stuff, you know, it's going to be really, really good. No, but let's talk about music anyway. So, I mean, you had an album out in 2015, We Came as Romans, as your name, as well as the band. Are you already writing songs for a new album that's going to come, hopefully, very soon?
Yeah, I mean, we're pretty much always writing, but... right now, like, we're getting to the point where we're starting to speed up the process a little bit more and buckle down a little bit more on, like, the writing and the brainstorming. But, it's still in, like, the really early phases because we're probably not even going to record till maybe the winter or so. So we're still pretty early on it. But, we're always writing just to keep our brains sharp, you know, and keep the practice up.
And is he, like, writing about things that you, like, you know, experience here in Greenfield or wherever in the world? Or is it, you know, or is it, like, more things that go on in the world? Like things that you experience or things that, you know, just happen?
I think it's more about things that go on in the world, more so than like the places we've been. Yeah. But I mean, it's still really early in the writing process, so we'll see where a lot of the writing goes.
So there's still a chance there will actually be a song about cheese and goldfish then?
Yeah, for sure.
We hope so. Album coming out, 2019, Cheese and Goldfish.
Cheese and Goldfish.
The first two singles, I guess, then.
Kyle might... I don't think Kyle would be in the band anymore if that was the case.
He'll just run off, go somewhere else. Also, Jens Körka, sie sind momentan am Schreiben für das neue Album, wo hoffentlich bald rauskommt, aber momentan haben sie gesagt, sie müssen das Ganze ein bisschen schneller machen, ein bisschen mehr anfangen, weil sonst wird es eigentlich nicht schlussendlich. Und doch, wenn sie dann auch irgendwie an den Fans euch da draußen können, ein neues Album präsentieren, das ihr nachher auch gut findet. Wahrscheinlich nicht mit dem Titel Käse und Goldfisch, aber doch Sachen, die sie dann, wo in der Welt passieren, haben sie gesagt, mehr als Sachen, die sie dann selber erleben, überall auf der Welt grundsätzlich. Aber wir werden es sehen, er weiß es noch nicht, doch sind sie noch alles eigentlich erst noch am Schreiben. Well, then I guess you'll be going on stage later, making a big rockfest here at the Greenfield, and I guess you'll have a lot of fun. And well, I guess thank you very much for the interview then.
Yeah,
rock
man.
Stage.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.